Students, welcome to yet another session of my class Reading Fiction. We are discussing Animal Farm by George Orwell. Let us continue the summary of Animal Farm. Yes, another commandment is changed to read, no animal shall kill any other animal without cause. Yes, in the first part itself we see, yes, there are seven commandments released for the betterment of animal life. And slowly things changed. That is, pigs are the most intellectual animals in that farm, and Napoleon took over all the control of the farm, and they slowly tried to change the commandments according to their benefit. And now, yes, another commandment is changed to read. That is, no animal shall kill any other animal without cause. That means they can kill other animal if any necessary cause they have. So no animal shall kill any other animal without cause. So they have the power to, or they have the freedom to kill other animal if any necessary cause. So Clover and Muriel convinced themselves that the commandment has always been this way. Yes, they try to convince themselves that all the commandments have always been this way. All the commandments, that is, slowly all the commandments have changed according to their benefit. And this Clover and Muriel, they convince themselves that the commandment has always been in this way. Then Squealer begins reading the animal statistics regularly to convince them that production is increasing. And Squealer begins reading the animal statistics. Yes, they try to understand the attitude and the mind of the animals regularly and try to convince them that production is increasing, that is, animal farm is in good right path, that is, in the prospering way. Actually, Squealer try to convince these other animals that production is increasing and they are okay. Napoleon seldom appears in public. Yes, Napoleon, after that, this Napoleon, that is their leader, never appears in public. And the animals now call him our leader, comrade Napoleon. Maybe one more question may be asked from, yes, all other animals call Napoleon as their leader, our leader, comrade Napoleon. They attribute all misfortunes to Snowball and all success and luck to Napoleon. Yes, these animals, they were convinced badly or wrongly, and they attribute all misfortunes to Snowball. They believe that all misfortunes, it is happened, it is because of Snowball. And all success and luck to, they attribute all success, all goodness and luck to Napoleon, and they attribute all misfortunes to Snowball. Napoleon continues to negotiate with the farmers and eventually decides to sell the timber to Mr. Pilkington. Yes, he continued to negotiate or try to make discussions with or try to tie up with the human beings or human masters of the neighboring farm, and continues to negotiate with the farmers, and eventually decides, at last he decides to sell the timber of the animal farm to Mr. Pilkington, that is a human master of the neighboring farm. At last the windmill is finished and named Napoleon Mill. See, at last, yes, after some time, that the construction of the windmill is finished and named it as Napoleon Mill. See how the things change in that animal farm. There are seven commandments, and in that the seventh commandment is the most, that is, all animals are equal. Here things change, that is, at last, yes, one windmill is finished in the animal farm. It is named as Napoleon Mill, not animal mill or something like animal windmill or something like that. They named it as, or he named it as, Napoleon Mill. That shows his authoritarianism, or that shows his power, that control over other animals, how he tried to suppress other animals in the animal farm. From this naming, we can understand that. Then, soon after, Napoleon announces that he will sell the timber to Frederick, quickly changing his allegiance and disavowing his earlier vilification of Frederick. Yes. And soon after, Napoleon announces that he will, yes, in the earlier session we saw that, yes, he made a tie-up with Mr. Pilkington. He decides to sell the timber to Pilkington. But soon after, Napoleon announces that he will sell the timber to Frederick, another human master of a neighboring farm. And that is quickly changing his allegiance and disavowing his earlier vilification of Frederick. Napoleon says that Pilkington and Snowball have been collaborating. That's why his decision changed. He says that Pilkington and Snowball have been collaborated. They made some collaboration in between Pilkington and Snowball. So he changed his decision to sell the timber to Frederick. Frederick pays for the timber in fake cash. And the next morning, Frederick and his men invade the farm and blow up the windmill. Yes, the next day, Frederick pays for the timber in fake cash. And the next morning itself, he and his men entered into the animal farm and tried to invert the farm. Yes, tried to invert and blow up the windmill. But the animals managed to chase the humans off, though many die or are injured in what they call the battle of the windmill. One more question may be asked. That is the battle of the windmill. In the earlier session, I mentioned one battle named the battle of the cowshed. And now another battle is mentioned in the summary. That is the battle of the windmill. Here the context is animals. Yes, this Napoleon decided to sell the timber to Mr. Frederick, and Mr. Frederick, yes, pays for the timber in fake cash. And the next morning itself, he entered into the animal farm. He tried to invert the farm and blow up the windmill, and the animals managed to chase the humans off. And in that revolution or rebellion against Mr. Frederick, many of the animals had died and some other are injured, and they called it as the battle of the windmill. After the battle, the pigs discover a case of whiskey in the farmhouse. Yes, after the battle, yes, the pigs, they discovered a case of whiskey in the farmhouse. They drink to excess. These pigs, they drink to excess, and soon Squealer reports that Napoleon is dying, and as his last action, has made the consumption of alcohol punishable by death. Actually, there is a commandment in the first releasing. There is an important. Is a commandment already released that no animal shall ever drink alcohol, but it is changed here. They drink to these pigs, they discover a case of whiskey in the farmhouse, and they drink to excess this whiskey. And soon Squealer reports that Napoleon is dying, and as his last action, has made the consumption of alcohol punishable by death. This, from these instances, we can understand that, yes, some of the animals got the lifestyle of man. Some of the animals adopted those lifestyle and the attitude of human beings, like human masters, that is like Napoleon and pigs, etc. And they changed all the commandments according to their benefit and according to their interest. That is what we see here in the progress of summary. But Napoleon recovers quickly and then sends Bimber to procure manuals on brewing alcohol. Squealer changes another commandment, and Napoleon recovers quickly and then Squealer changes another commandment to: no animal shall drink alcohol to excess. To excess is in italics. That means they can drink alcohol, but don't drink in excess.
That means all the commandments, all the seven commandments, they change during the course of the time. No animal shall drink alcohol to excess. Then Napoleon plans to build a schoolhouse for the 31 young pigs he has parented. I already told you these pigs are the most intellectual animals in that farm. And slowly this Napoleon plans to build a schoolhouse for the 31 young pigs he has parented. Towards the end of the winter, Napoleon begins increasing propaganda to distract the animals from inequality and hardship. Yes, during the course of the time, Napoleon begins increasing propaganda to distract the animals from inequality and hardship. He creates special spontaneous demonstrations in which the animals march around and celebrate their triumphs. All these are actually the ideas of Napoleon to conceal his doings, etc. He tried to release propaganda to distract animals from, that is Clover, Muriel and some others. They try to understand that inequality is happening in their farm, or each and everything is changed. So he tried to conceal the attitude, or they try to distract animals, that is their mind should be distracted. So they try to release increasing propaganda to distract the mind of the other animals from that inequality and hardship. He creates special demonstrations, yes, like assembly or functions or something like that. He creates special, this Napoleon creates. I told you, that's why I told you that he is behaving like, or he adopted the lifestyle of a man. He is behaving like a man. His reign is like that. His power is like that. So he creates special spontaneous demonstrations in which animals march around and celebrate their triumphs, like a human being did in a function or assembly or something like that. In April, Napoleon declares the farm a republic and is elected unanimously as president. Yes, in 1 April, Napoleon declares that their farm is the farm a republic, and is elected unanimously, and he is elected unanimously as the president of the animal farm. The animals continue to work feverishly, most of all Boxer. Boxer means a workhorse in that animal farm. And the animals continue to work harder. And most of them were Boxer, that is a workhorse. One day, Boxer collapses. That means he did a lot of overload work, this Boxer. And one day, he tired and he collapses while overexerting himself. And Napoleon promises to send him to the veterinarian in Wellington. Yes, and Napoleon gave him a promise that, yes, I will take care of you. And promises to send him to the veterinary hospital in Wellington to take care of this Boxer. Actually, this was a wrong promise. A few days later, a horse slaughterer takes Boxer away in his van. Actually, that was happened in the animal farm. After a few days, a horse slaughterer came to that animal farm and took Boxer away in his van. The animals are none the wiser until Benjamin reads the lettering on the side of the van. Yes. I already told you all, only pigs are the intellectual animals and they could read. These pigs could read, and along with these pigs, the only other one is Benjamin, who can read letters. But that means who got some primary education, this Benjamin. So the animals are none the wiser, that is he is a wiser one. This a Benjamin, and the wiser, that is a Benjamin, reads the lettering on the side of the van. That means that one is from a horse slaughterhouse. The van is from a horse slaughter house. And a few days later, Schuyler reports that Boxer died in the hospital despite receiving the best possible care. And after some days, Schuyler reported in the animal farm that Boxer was died in the hospital
despite receiving the best possible care. That is, he is trying to convince other animals that they gave better treatment and better care to the boxer. Actually, Napoleon, yes, sell this animal. Napoleon sell this boxer to horse slaughterer for money. And this boxer was the one who did a lot of work for Napoleon and for that animal farm. But this Napoleon never cared this boxer and other animals. And he claims that boxer's last words glorified animal farm and Napoleon. Actually, this killer is trying to convince the mind of other animals. And he claims that boxer's last words are glorified animal farm and Napoleon. Actually, this Napoleon sell this animal boxer for money to a horse slaughterer. And they killed this animal, this boxer. But killer here reported that he died in the hospital, in the veterinary hospital, despite receiving the best possible care. And this killer, he also claims that the van belongs to the veterinarian who recently bought it from the horse slaughter and had not yet managed to paint over the lettering. And again he is trying to convince other animals that he claims that van belongs to the veterinary hospital. And this van this doctor who recently bought it from a horse slaughter and had not yet managed to paint over the lettering. That means Benjamin and other pigs can read the letters in the van. And Benjamin tried to understand what is the reality. And so he is trying to convince the other animals that yes, this one is bought from the horse slaughterer recently and had not yet managed to paint over the lettering. And Napoleon promises to honor Boxer with a special banquet. And Napoleon offers his promises to honor the body or honor Boxer with a special banquet, but the pigs use the money from his slaughter to buy a case of whiskey. That means Napoleon sell this boxer for money, and he kept that money in his room. But the pigs use that money from his slaughter to buy a case of whiskey, which they drink on the day appointed for the banquet. Yes, Napoleon organized one day, that is to honor Boxer with a special banquet. But the big pigs use that money from his slaughter to buy a case of whiskey, which they drink on the same day, that is the day appointed for the banquet. Years go by, and though animal farms population has increased, only a few animals that remember the rebellion remain. Yes, and years passed, and though animal farms population has increased, only a few animals that remember the rebellion remain. Conditions are still harsh despite technological improvements. Yes, conditions are very bad despite the technological improvements in the animal farm, because these poor animals, they worked very hard for their living conditions. The pigs and dogs continue to do no manual labor. Yes, these pigs and dogs, these pigs are the most intellectual animals under the reign of Napoleon, and they are very close to Napoleon, and dogs are the securities of Napoleon. So the pigs and dogs continue to do no manual labor, instead devoting themselves to organizational work. Yes, these pigs and dogs are devoted to, or they were posted themselves to organizational work, that is in administration or something like that. And all the other animals, they did all the hard work and the manual work in the animal farm. That shows the inequality that is existing in the animal farm, like in the human society. So one day, Squealer takes the sheep out to a deserted pasture where he says he is teaching them a song. Yes, one day, this Squealer takes the sheep out to a distant place, that is a deserted area, that is a pasture, where he says, the Squealer says to this sheep that he is teaching them a song. On the day the sheep returned, the pigs walk around the yard on their hind legs as the sheep chant, four legs good, two legs better. Yes. And when the sheep returned to the animal farm, they saw that the pigs walk around the yard on their hind legs. That means they walk around like human beings. That is in two legs. The pigs walk around the yard on their hind legs as the sheep chant, four legs good, two legs better. That means their earlier commandment is changed now. In the initial time, we see that the commandment was four legs good and two legs bad. Now it is changed to four legs good and two legs better. And now this, the pigs are behaved like human beings and they walk around like human beings. They walk around the yard on their hind legs as the sheep chant, four legs good and two legs better. The other animals are horrified. Clover consults the barn wall again. This time, Benjamin reads to her. The seven commandments have been replaced with a single maxim. All animals are equal, but some animals are more equal than others. That is what is happening in that animal farm. All animals are equal. Actually, the seventh commandment is now changed. All the seven commandments are changed and the seventh one is all animals are equal in animal farm. And the seven commandments have been replaced with a single maxim. That is, all the seven commandments are replaced with a single commandment. And that is, what is that? Maybe one more question may be asked. That is, all animals are equal, but some animals are more equal than others. That is, this time Benjamin reads to her, reads to Clover. It is the Benjamin who reads to Clover that this, all the seven commandments have been replaced with a single commandment. That is, all maxim, all animals are equal, but some animals are more equal than others. This is the one of the most famous lines in Animal Farm. The pigs continue the long-lasting pattern of awarding themselves more and more privileges. Yes, they are the more privileged animals in the animal farm. And the pigs continue the long-standing pattern of, that is, they try to award themselves more and more privileges. They buy it.